Welcome to the first video for the Visual Programming Basic course. This video will cover the basics of Rhino, and since this course is actually on the Rhino plugin Grasshopper, that's all the Rhino skills you will need for this course. Essentially, what we'll be using Rhino for is to look at the models we generate with Grasshopper and maybe to draw some input curves. That's about it. So let's get started. When you open up Rhino, you'll see something that should be familiar to you if you've used other CAD programs. We have a command line, which will tell you what it's expecting from you, give you options, bunch of commands as icons, and four viewports. Now, to better understand these, I've prepared a few boxes, and you can see that we have a perspective view, a top, a front, and a right view. To move around in these viewports, you can drag with your right mouse button and then you can pan. In the perspective, this won't pan, this will rotate. So to pan in the perspective, you use the shift button and the right mouse button. Scroll wheel does what you would expect, it zooms in and out. And if you would like to maximize one of these four views, you simply double click on its name. And double clicking will also take you back, and you can toggle between the four different views down here in the little tabs. So let's double click and go back to the four views. Now the views are rendered in this way by default, but you can change the way these different views are rendered. If you click on the little arrow here, you'll see a bunch of different presets, for example, shaded. And you can also customize all of this down here in the display options. So what I've prepared is a white background to make it a little bit easier to see what we're doing later on in the Grasshopper. So let's clean up our model space. I'm going to double click the perspective here. Selection works the same way as in other CAD programs. If you drag from left to right, it'll only select what's inside the box entirely. And if you drag the other direction, it'll select everything that is touched by that box. So let's go delete. Now, to draw a curve, I'm going to go back to all four and also change the look of the other four viewports. Here we go. Now, to start drawing a curve, we can either click on the control point curve icon here or enter the command. Rhino does have autocomplete, so there you go. And it'll ask you for a start of curve. Up here you can see it in the command line, it'll ask you, please tell me where to start the curve. And behind it you'll see a bunch of options for that curve. Now this degree option is something we'll get into later, but generally if you want to change the options of command, you click on them and then it'll ask you, hey, what's the degree supposed to be? I'm going to leave it at the default, so I'm just going to hit enter. Now, when I move the mouse, it moves the cursor in all four views. And you can change in the middle, so you can start drawing a line in one view and then finish drawing it in the other. Now, if you want to work along the grid, you can turn on the grid snap. There is also an object snap, which you can then customize down here with these checkboxes. Set start, put it at the origin, I'm going to make a very simple kind of curve. And to end, you right click or hit enter. So this curve is basically lying on the bottom of our model space. If I wanted to have one which was standing upright, I could draw a curve in the front or the right view. Here we go, draw a different curve. There we go, you can see it's standing upright. Now if you try drawing curves in perspective mode, it usually gets kind of weird. So let's say, to repeat a command, you right click and repeat it. So let's say I want to do a second curve kind of here. So I'm going to go click, 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 finish. And what's actually done is drawn on the bottom of the world again. So drawing in perspective mode usually isn't that nice. It's usually easier just to draw in one of the other viewports. For example, I could do this. I have two curves. And they both lie on the same plane, but I could then later go to the top view, for example, and if you click on something which has got several options, so here the curves are lying underneath each other, it'll actually give you a nice little selection menu. And now I'm going to just select the smaller one and then drag it away to the plane where I actually want to have it. If we want to later on edit the curvature, so the place where these control points were placed, you have to use the control points command. And that is down here. It's called points on. If you select points on, nothing will happen, except in the command line it says, hey, select objects for control points to display. And I'm going to select this curve and then right click or hit enter. And now I can drag around these control points and change the shape of the curve. Now, if you start doing this in perspective mode, your curve will start going weird. So here it's very useful to then turn on the gumball down here. And the gumball, once you have it on and select something, it'll give you three arrows, namely the axes, so X, Y, and Z, and then you can drag it around in a very controlled manner. So I've only changed it in this plane up here, or I could, you know, shift it over here on purpose, for example. Now that's essentially all you need to know for Rhino. You need to know how to get to the viewport which you want. You need to know how to drag around control points and draw curves. That's all you're going to need for this Grasshopper course. If you do want to learn more, there is a Rhino Basics course at our university, but I will also be uploading a set of links to YouTube tutorials which go into all the details of Rhino and which I used to learn Rhino back when I started. Thank you for watching.